13. Untuk apa kamu ada di sini sekarang?
Wanna be like a deja vu then?
Yeah, it's okay, Timo. You know, I have so many questions for you that I decided to mold it around for the second round. Also, I just saw that you finished filming on Nobody 2 yesterday. How did that go?
Went great, man. Like I feel relieved, you know, like it's my first studio film.
Really? Yeah.
I thought it's going to be much easier because I'm so used to doing tough shootings, but it's actually quite hard, you know. But like, look, in the end, I didn't make any enemies, and you know what? I work with some of the best people in the business, especially Bob, who's such an amazing guy, you know.
Yeah.
Almost like a father figure at the end, you know. So I love it, man.
Oh, that's so sweet to hear. And I mean, I would have been surprised if you would have made enemies. Like, you seem like a generally great guy. And also to go back on the Shadow Strays, once again, we talked about it, but really, really love the film. I love how you crafted this epic crime film. I was a big fan of The Night Comes for Us, and I see some similarities in the way you're building the stories. Always a great job with like introducing colorful characters, some of them over the top, some of them has a lot of depth to it. So I'm just curious, what is your process when crafting the characters? Like, when do you know a character is working out during the process?
Well, I think I always start from writing from characters first. I feel like, okay, what kind of characters do I want to tell? For example, for Night Comes to Us, I was actually a bit inspired by Shogun Assassin, which is Lone Wolf and Cub. You know, like I always feel, well, shit. You know, even his name, his character name Ito, is like actually from Ogami Ito, which is the main character in Lone Wolf and Cub. So in this case, like with the Shadow Strays, I kind of always like the idea of like making a very sort of like badass character that just happens to be a young female. You know, like I love myself those films, the Golden Era Luc Besson, La Femme Nikita. You know, like I love Leon, and I always wonder, like, fuck, you know, like, in a weird way, I do want like a sequel from Leon, just because like the ending kind of like hints so much at what could have become, you know. And it obviously it never happened, and that's why that film is timeless, because you never get to see what happened after that. And I think in a weird way, the character 13 is sort of came out of this, all this sort of like fantasies and this sort of like little kind of like, what if we do this, like, you know, like in my head, you know, like, and I kind of like the idea of like a character that is both innocent and at the same time cold-blooded. So I started to write from there, and I started to write from a, what if she has this stoic sort of like almost samurai-like master, you know? And from then the character, the story just expand. That's why I always feel like I'm a character writer first and a plot writer much later. You know,
it shows that you put so much art into those characters, and at the end of the day, when you're watching a movie, this is like one of the most important things. And there's always like so many new characters showing up, and you give them all an arc, which I really appreciate. But you just talk about some blood. I know that you have a solid background in horror, which you work in the VHS film, and I feel like it's really interesting how you're, it kind of like incorporate that into your action sequences with all the blood and the gore. So how would you say your horror background is helping you when directing action?
Yes, I like I said before, like I think a lot of my approach, like my approach to violence, is the fact that I kind of respect violence, you know. I respect and both fear it, you know. So I always am a firm believer that you have to present violence in an honest manner, you know. Sometimes honesty in violence is sometimes over the top, you know. I would never sort of like say to myself, I'll push it as far as something like the story of Ricky, for example, because at that point I feel it's less traumatizing and more funny, you know, and cool, you know. Like I love the story of Ricky, but like I feel like I just have to draw the line a bit where, and of course, like people have a different sort of like a level of what is over the top and what is not, but like I always feel like, well, no, like we have to be able to be honest in terms of like how far does a human body, is a human body able to receive punishment, you know? And I think that's how I try to portray violence. You know, I love body horror, and the thing is, like, I don't think I can make it in Indonesia just because it's such a unusual concept. So the closest thing that I can do is like, kind of like, all right, let's make an action film where the body receives a lot of trauma and be able to stand for it, you know, like be able to die hard for it, you know.
Yeah, and would you say like there's some video game influences in your film? Because you use a lot of POV shots. For example, when someone is holding a weapon, you would see it as if you're playing like a first-person video game. Would you
Definitely
say you
yes. I
incorporate
mean,
them in your film? Yeah.
I make no mistake. I make no. I don't hide the fact that sometimes I'm terrified that how good video game has become, that maybe one day filmmakers cease to exist just because, you know, like I publicly has said, like, one, The Last of Us is one of my favorite sort of game, and I think when I was writing The Shadow Strays, there's a lot of that kind of like strong female protect, you know, like anti-hero sort of like that comes to my mind. But also, video game can do a lot of what movies can't, you know, like, and so I think there's nothing wrong with if video games are influenced by movie, then a filmmaker that is trying to sort of like walk the line can also be influenced by video games, you know.
Absolutely. No, I by the way, I mean that as a big compliment. I really love how you work with also the recent VHS segment you made was completely batshit crazy.
Oh
Anyway,
yeah,
let's stay on target though. I really love the
that's
details and the love that you put in the production design and the costume in that film and the Shadow Stray. So just really like how exactly did you collaborate with them? Because they all have like there's an importance with the masks and all the costume. I feel like you put a lot of importance into that.
Well, the mask is definitely something that I always feel is something that is very important in The Shadow Strays, just because one of the theme that I want to explore is like the duality of characters, you know, like and like for example, 13 is both innocent and cold-blooded, you know, and then there's this other character who's a cop, but like he's also corrupt and in a weird way a closeted guy, you know. So he wears a mask too. And then there's the corrupt politician's son who's a daddy's boy, but at the same time he's also sadistic. You know, he has this fetishistic feeling for being an alpha male, you know, like so I think wearing a mask is like some of those are very sort of like sexy idea to do that just because here's the thing, why do Batman wear a mask, right? Because in some way there is that kind of like thing with him where he gains power when he wears this mask, you know, like and I always love that idea. I always love mask as a representation of two different side of people, you
I
know.
love it. That's a great
Yeah.
answer because that's something I felt like you put a lot of emphasis on it in the movie, and I really
Yes,
like
I try
that.
to. Thank you for noticing.
No problem. And also, I'm just curious, like, what's a dream project you would have? Like, if something you could do, what would you do?
I would love, here's the thing, like it's always flip-flopping with me. I love Lone Wolf and Cub is like always been has been one of my favorite thing, and I think a lot of people want to remake that thing, you know, like, and I feel like I don't want to be joining the competition with that one. Maybe someday I'll just do a Indonesian version of Lone Wolf and the Cub, you know, like that's not that hard, you know. But like one thing that I really want to do is a shot at Guy Fur. I think I always love Guy Fur just because I don't know if you know Guy Fur, like this Japanese character, which
Oh
is
yeah.
yes,
No,
it's
that's
like
a great. I think you got your head into something right now.
just because Guy Fur is, you know, like you have a guy who's given this alien sort of like armored suit. But at the same time, it also acts a little bit like a body horror thing, you know? And I think approaching something like Guy Fur or like Mask Rider, like, you know, which is very popular in Japan, from the angle where this thing that they wear also affects them psychologically and physically, it's always an amazing thing. I want to see this kind of like creation just because I want to have an excuse for, you know, like this cool bio weapon where you can punch like a mutant monster, and then that mutant monster becomes like, you know, like explode, you know. I want to do that. You know, it's
Listen,
like,
if I had the money, I would give it to you right now. It sounds
thank you,
like it
man.
sounds
Thank
like
you.
an awesome thing.
Yeah.
And or good to go back on the Shadow Strays. What would you say is the thing you're the most proud of? Is it a scene or a shot? Is there a moment you're like, fuck yeah,
Well,
I pulled that off?
I think that I'm most proud of the fact that like one of the reasons why I made The Shadow Strays is also like a sort of like a challenge for myself. I've been fortunate to be able to work with somebody like Joe Taslim and then Iko Uwais, who are amazing performers. You know, like they are sports people. You know, like they are hardcore judo master and silat masters. You know, like so. Sometimes I ask myself, hey, am I making these films just because it's so easy to have the kind of like kick ass? And one of the thing that I made as a personal mission in The Shadow Strays was I want to cast somebody as these two main characters who has never done action before, you know, and I want to push them to the limit if they want it, you know, like, and then I want to say to them, this will be worth it, you know, like, and I remember having that speech to Aurora, you know, like when I met her, I was like, Aurora, like this is going to be so hard. You might cry. You might probably want to give up in the middle, but like, I promise you, when we finish this thing, like it'll be so worth it, and you're going to be proud of it, you know.
And how did you help a young actress like that to make the transition into action? Because you mentioned last time we talked that it was like her first time doing action she never did before. Was it during the audition process? You talked a little bit about that. Like, how, at what point you were like, okay, she's the one.
Yes, I kind of, weirdly enough, like I kind of, especially with Aurora, just because, you know, like when I met her, she's 18 and she's weirdly innocent and goofy. At the same time, I also feel like she has been through a lot in life. And the way I approach it to her is almost like, you know, now that I'm older, like I was like, man, she's truly like a kid that my third kid. I always call her my third kid, you know. I have two daughters and I always say like, you are my third daughter, you know, like, and I said to her like, Aurora, like I know like it sucks that you have to train while people at your age, they are going to nightclubs and stuff, but she keeps pushing herself. And you know what, and in that night in Toronto when she finally see the film, like she's like, this is one of the best moments in my life that I will never forget. And I said, like, well, there you go. This is why we make movies for, because like you want to have this experience. You want to be there with the audience cheering for you, you know, like, and that for me is like one of my biggest achievement, you know, like to be able to have somebody as young and as fresh as she is and kind of like show that the world is your oyster, you know, like you don't need to be stuck in this little pool. Like you have the capacity to be bigger, you know. That's always a nice dream to share.
I
Yeah.
think it's one of the biggest strength of a director is being able to direct like young talent like that, and you did a great job with her. Is it someone you want to bring on board for a next project or maybe a sequel for that film? Not to to hint at anything.
I'm not gonna lie, like people always say like, hey Timo, like stop trying to do that universe building like John Wick. But like honestly, I always loved universe building from my first film. Even my first film, Macabre, I always try to hint out that there's a bigger world behind it, you know, like, and the same goes for The Shadow Strays, you know, like when I wrote the script, I already knew like, well, some of these characters, the ones that survive, or even the ones that doesn't survive, what a beautiful thing if you tell more about the backstory of this character, you know. I think some of the beauty with creating a character is you don't need to know what's their background. You just need to be able to make people be curious. Hey, what was his or her life before this thing, you know? And that's what I want to do. Like I think with the Shadow Strays, especially, you know, you've seen the ending, you know, like I just feel like there's so much more room there. Like, I mean, like, who is this other character? Like, why does she or he has a specific feeling to 13? You know, like, and I want to
Yeah.
explore that, you know?
Without spoiling anything, when I saw the actor, I mean, I jump out of my seat. I'm like, let's go. I mean, I'm
Yeah,
down for
man.
the
Like,
next one.
he's, you know, that actor is like, I always want to work with him, and I feel like now is the chance. Like, I mean, now that he's older than he was in when we. When the film that he's known for, I think in a way it's much more badass because the dynamics between these two characters is going to be awesome, you know? Yeah.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. I really thank you for your time, Timo, and giving me the
Thank you
chance to do
very much.
the to go for a second round. I know you probably need to celebrate the end of your shoot for Nobody
Oh no,
too.
man, I'm flying back tomorrow. Like I'm so tired. Like I feel bad to my crew. Like it's like, hey, Timo, let's go for a drink. But yesterday I literally can't move, man. My body's like giving up. I was like, you know what? It's time to go back to Jakarta and sleep in my apartment for a week, you know?
Oh yeah. You deserve
Yeah.
it. Like you watch some good things like
I
on
do.
screen.
Like I want to watch Rebel Ridge. I want to watch a lot of stuff, you know? Like
Rebel Ridge is great. Jeremy Saulnier
yes,
is
and
an awesome
again,
director.
I always say like Jeremy Saulnier, it's a more disciplined, more mature filmmaker than me, because like he always tried to find, hey, now that I'm so good at violence, how can I do the opposite of it? You know, like, and I'm like, every time I want to do that, I'm always going back to my weakness. Like, no, I have to make this messy and bloody, you know,
Well,
like.
don't never change. Always keep being yourself, Timo,
Hey,
because you do
someday
some
I will make
awesome
a
stuff.
kids movie. I promise you, man. Like, I love kids, you know, and I want to make kids movie. If Takashi Miike can make Ninja Kids, so can I, you know. I'll make it someday. Yeah.
Awesome. Thanks for your time, Timo,
Thank
and
you,
I
man.
really
Give you my
appreciate it.
shirt. Thank you very much.
Yes, I went with
But you
Evil
know
Dead this
what?
time.
You know what? Sharon Stone just told me like that's one of her favorite horror films.
Sharon Stone?
Yeah, she loved it. You know, like she watched that film and she's so impressed by Sam Raimi. She fought for him to be the director of The Quick and the Dead. She's an amazing woman.
Really, I always loved the title Dead by Dawn. I really wish like it was the official title like in cinemas because I feel it's called Evil Dead in most places, but Dead
Ah,
by
fuck. All
Dawn.
right. This is Dead by Dawn, right? Like,
Yeah, it's
sorry,
the
I saw
second
the
one.
picture. See,
It's
that's the
this,
picture.
yeah.
Like, usually when you see that picture, like the front, like you thought it's
Yeah.
Army of Darkness, you know, like because
No,
like
it's the it's the second one. Look, yeah, it's Evil Dead. It's Evil
Evil
Dead
Dead 2.
2.
Yes, because like it
Yeah.
has a similar picture of Ash illustration, you know,
You're
like
right.
so I only see it this much. And
Yeah.
she did watch like Army of Darkness and she really loved it.
Okay, so Army of Darkness is like her favorite one. Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah,
That's
she's
interesting.
great. She's very good in genre films, so yeah.
Well, keep building those strong relationship and you'll keep surrounding about, you know, with great people and great actors because you deserve all all the praise you're getting. Yeah.
Thank you, Matthew. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Have a good one, Timo.
Have
Enjoy
a
your
good
time.
one. Thank you very much, man.
Yes, thank you.
Bye.